I'm trying to do. They put so many things on you to be a good parent now. You know, they want you to do all the rules. And my son came out. He came out. It was 15 below in Iowa where we were. He's like, he comes out and we're bored. He's like, Dad, you want to play a board game? And inside my head, I'm like, damn. On the outside, I'm like, okay. So he goes, I go, what do you want to play? He goes, Clue. Remember Clue? That was a good game, right? I said, oh, yeah. Clue. You remember Clue? You had a dark box and had all these crazy things going on the inside. You solve a murder. He looks at me. He comes out. He's got this white box in his hand. And a kid on it with a watermelon smiley face. And a cupcake with a rainbow over it. I go, well, what the heck is that? He goes, it's Clue Jr. I go, what do you do? He goes, it's really cool, Dad. What you got to do is you got to find out what kid ate the cupcake and in what room of the school he ate it in. I go, really? Because when I was 11, you had to figure out who bludgeoned the colonel to death in the kitchen with a candlestick. Happy Thanksgiving, buddy. Happy Thanksgiving. But you'll see, man, you have kids, you're going to have them someday, I guarantee it. You're going to see the rules that are put on you. As soon as you get your kid out of the hospital, what do you need? Car seat. You can't leave with your kid that you made without a car seat. We didn't have car seats growing up, did we? No, your car seat was like mine. It was on my mom's lap. My dad hit the brakes, I hit the dashboard every time. There were kids falling off the speaker area on the freaking board down below. You ever try buckling up a newborn? It's like strapping in a bowling ball. The head's like... You're trying to hold it up. Is he breathing? Is he breathing? That's why I don't believe in ADD, attention deficit disorder. These kids just don't want to get in a car seat at 2 years old. You ever been strapped into a roller coaster? You get out, you want to go. You get a kid in the seat for 2 hours, that little bastard ain't going to get caught again, man. He's like, you ain't catch me, I ain't getting in that crap again. Everything you get him. I got my son a new bike for Christmas this year. What do you got to get with bikes? Helmets. Yeah, helmets. What's your name, man? Colin. Let me ask you a question, Colin. I want every guy in the room to think back. What would have happened to you, Colin, if you showed up at the park with a bike helmet when you were a kid? You got the crap beat out of you. Nice helmet, Colin! Helmets. You go to the parks with your kids now, you will see how safe the park is. The ground is shredded rubber. The slides are plastic. Everything else is Nerf. You can't get hurt at a park. What were parks made when we were kids? Concrete, metal, wood, sharp stuff. Who was building our parks? Hitler? If we left the park not needing a tetanus shot, we had a good day. I'm with my daughter, right? She's two. This is 13 years ago. I look at this kid. I'm looking at the rubber stuff. I'm like, look at this. I see a kid 20 feet up on the monkey bars, hanging upside down. He falls head first into the rubber stuff, bounces off his neck, and jumped on the next slide. I was like, did you see that? If a kid did that when we were little, where was he next year? On the short bus going to school. Am I right? It was concrete, man. We had dangerous rides when we were kids. We had the spin around merry-go-round ride. Remember that ride? Yeah, Teflon lubricated for super speed. Always one big psycho kid wanting to pull 6 G's on that thing. 2 minutes in the ride, skinny kids are going, slow down, man! Slow down, please slow down, slow down, slow down, please! You get the strength to pull yourself up and you hit that no gravity zone, you're like, oh God! Oh, I need my helmet. We got hurt. Nobody really cared. Can't leave your kids in the car anymore by themselves? That's against the law. You're all laughing because, you know, so you got a new, now you got to unstrap the newborn, go and get your cigarettes and beer, get back in the freaking car. That's a real pain. Sometimes you want to lock the door, run in, get your stuff and get out. We were kids, my dad, he put us in the car, he locked us in the car 2-3 hours a clip. He didn't care. We would ask for too much stuff in the supermarket. He would do the same thing every time. I mean, he would leave us for 2 hours, and what was the only thing you could do while you waited for your parents? You yelled stuff at the other people coming out of the store. And it was always the same thing. It was me and my brother Keith, right? He talked like Joe Pesci since I was 7. He talked just like this. And that's scary when you got a 9-year-old calling you a douchebag. And every time my dad would leave, he'd take over like a general. My dad's like, don't touch anything stupid. I'll be right back. My brother would be like, all right. Here we go. Watch this. Here comes one. Look at this guy. Oh, it's a chick. I thought it was a guy. All right. Watch this. Shut up. Watch this. Shut up. Watch this. Hey, fat ass big tits! That was hilarious. Stay down. Stay down. Yeah, that was hilarious. You see your face? Oh, shit. Then you hear this. Holy shit, she's out the window! No, don't look up though! Oh, God, here comes Pop. Yeah, then we hear my father. Hey, fat ass big tits, quit pounding on my car!